Hi everyone, I'm makeup artist Jenna Anton and I'm here today with
Candace Swanepoel.
And we're here today to show you how to recreate the look from the VS Fantasies campaign. In this particular shot, Candace is looking very seductive with a beautiful pink lip and a bronzy, smoky eye. So the first step in recreating any makeup look is to make sure to even out your skin tone. When picking the perfect color for you, pick three colors that you think might work for your skin tone. Put a little bit on the back of your hand and just do a quick swipe right along the jawbone. Whichever one disappears, that's the color for you. Let's contour with Beat, the Victoria's Secret Tinted Moisturizer. You can use a brush, a sponge, your finger, whatever you're comfortable with. And when contouring, you just want to think about where the sun naturally hits the face, which is going to be the temples of the forehead, right along the bottom of the cheekbones, and don't forget the neck. You can also hit a little bit of the bottom of the chin. And you want to do this before you do your regular tinted moisturizer. This just helps give depth to the face. And it's also a great way to really warm up the skin tone. So once we finish contouring, you're gonna take her color, which is medium, and apply it to the middle of the forehead, down the nose, along the cheek area. Pretty much a reverse triangle, just to kind of brighten up the middle of the face. So the next step after evening out the skin tone is to do concealer. This is a great palette. It's got, you know, light, medium, and dark. The green one, you know, if you have a pimple, this will totally neutralize the red, and then you put your regular skin tone right after it. And if you have any sort of dark spots, this red color is really great at evening out dark spots. I like to use the back of my hand just so I don't put too much product directly on the skin. A lot of times when using an oil-free concealer, if you go directly from the palette to the skin, they drag, they go on very heavy. So if you put a little bit on the back of your hand, it kind of melts and then it makes for a really easy application. Now time to move on to the eyes. I've chosen In Between the Sheets, which is a really beautiful bronze color. Take your brush, dip it right into your color. Starting on the outer corners of the eyes, you just want to pat it and work your way in. I think this is a really beautiful color on a blue eyes. And I feel like a lot of women have the misconception that if you have blue eyes, you should stick to blues and greens, and if you have browns, you should stick to the browns. But I believe
it's the opposite.
Yes, absolutely. When you have a contrast behind there, it really gives you that chance to make the eye color pop. So when you just open your eye, having that bronzy backdrop, just the blue really jumps out at you. Again, just start on the outer corner.
Look straight ahead.
Just blend it kind of 3/4 of the way in. And we're going to just drag the same color right onto the bottom lash line, about 3/4 of the way in. That looks so pretty. The next step is to highlight the inner corners of the eye, and we've chosen Sparkle, which is this really beautiful gold color. You can use a brush or your fingers, you just wanna take it, and you just wanna pop the color right on the inner corners of the eyes. And that just really makes the eyes just pop out at you. We're also going to take it and put it on the inner corner of the upper lid. Kind of blend it right into In Between the Sheets. We're going to finish off this look with mascara. VS Makeup has great formulas for mascara. They have the Voluptuous Volume, Triple Drama, High Definition. So whatever kind of look you're looking for your lashes, they have it. I think we're going to use the Voluptuous Volume today. I love the brush on this. And all you need is one coat. You want to separate the lashes as you're applying the mascara. So VS has a great collection of lip liners ranging in all sorts of colors, but we're going to use Candace's favorite color today, which is
nude.
Nude. You'll never see her without this color. So you say, why do you need a lip liner? I think it just really helps to even out the shape of the lips. It also gives your gloss or your lipstick something to hold on to. Let's put some lip color on there. To balance out this look, I don't want something so glossy on the lips, so we're gonna do something more of a matte stain. So we've chosen Hot Spot, which is a really gorgeous pink. So you just take it, put a little bit on the back of your hand, give me a little pout. There you go. There you go. We've chosen Spotlight, which is a really pretty shimmery pink lipstick. You want to take a little bit, put it right on a brush. You can use your finger too. Just put it right in the middle of the bottom lip. This is just going to make your lips look a little bit fuller. Also, a great little trick that a lot of people don't know about, if you highlight the bow area, that also gives the illusion of a fuller mouth. That looks gorgeous. Pretty. Thanks everyone for joining us. I had so much fun recreating the look from the VS Fantasies campaign.